Hello everyone, this is JT Gravity RC. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you an experiment that I've been thinking of doing for a long time, and which is, I think that the perfect camera-based flying is FPV and third-person view. Because as you know, when we drive or when we maybe fly a plane or anything like that, we do not need not just front view, we need back view and side to side view so that we can have orientation. And I also been playing video games last time, and I could never get into first person view gaming because it's always disorientating. I was switch between FPV and third person view. So what I done with this experiment is that I'm using JJRC X1. So I have this Cyma FPV Wi-Fi camera attached to the back of the JJRC X1 as a third person view camera, and I'm using this JXT509G FPV 5.8 GHz camera as the FPV camera for this experiment. So what I've done is I'm just attaching the screen using Velcro to my transmitter, and the Cyma FPV camera I'm going to use my phone as the screen. So I'm going to do a very short hovering test here and to let you see that it works. And with the third person view, you can see that you can actually see the quad itself so that you know where you are. And of course with the first person view, you can see the front. So I'm going to switch on the screen itself so you can see. So hopefully you can see the bulb of the screen. So what you get is you have the first person view, and then you also have the third person view. I'll bring it a bit closer so that you can see. See, you have the first person view and you have the third person view. So I think that's the best system for FPV. So this is a very crude experiment. Hopefully one day I myself or someone else can design a system where you can put maybe screen on screen or side by side screen, so that you know when you fly around, you know where you are and then where your orientation is by looking at the both screen together simultaneously. I hope this one can fly because with the brushless models, it's heavy enough to lift a GoPro camera. So I'm hoping that this will work for lifting both cameras together. So because I'm doing it in the house, I don't want to take too much risk. So I'm just doing a short hovering test and hopefully it will work. So I'm going to take photos of this and put it on my Facebook page, and so you can go and have a look. And this too, I haven't fixed the LED lights with the straw because they were broken earlier. So I'm going to fix them soon. So let's do a test hovering with this system and see whether it works or not. So you can leave both camera, so which I'm very happy. Thank you. But I need to be very careful because it's in the house. I don't want to damage anything. So I'm going to do this. So I'm letting you see the quadcopter first, and I'm going to put the screen in front of me, in front of the GoPro, so that you can see the screen later on. Okay. And I'm also going to mention that now with the transmitter mode with the LiPo battery, the transmitter seems to be more responsive now because due to the higher power of the LiPo battery. So which is, I'm quite happy about that. Okay guys, now it's LBC. I'm going to land it and I'm going to upload this video as soon as I can, and hopefully I've shown you enough and I have captured enough footage of the quad flying and also the video screen. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Oops. So I'm going to show you again. This is the video footage. See? This is the quad. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I think I can call this an experiment a success. So hope you guys enjoyed this. Until next time, if you like my video, please like and subscribe to my channel. This is JT Gravity RC signing up. So I'm going to upload the video as soon as possible. See you guys.